The Taliban emerged in 1994 as one of the leading factions in the Afghan Civil War. Recently, they've taken over the power of the Afghanistan government, just 2 weeks before the US was set to complete its troop withdrawal. The Taliban announced the war in Afghanistan over after it retook the capital, Kabul, with little resistance. It costs them 2 decades of war. Surprisingly, Russia and China have shaken their hands in this matter and mutually agreed to extend their helping hand to the Taliban to rebuild Afghanistan. They'll use diplomatic and economic inducements to influence the Taliban into a path of peaceful reconstruction. Putin told Xi that he shares China's judgments and concerns in Afghanistan and is willing to work together to prevent foreign forces from interfering and destroying Afghanistan. Hello everyone, welcome to World of China. In today's video, we are talking about the recent Taliban victory over Afghanistan and what's China's next diplomatic approach or interest in this global affair. Stay tuned with us and make sure you hit the subscribe button. The Taliban declared victory after Ashraf Ghani, Afghanistan's president, fled the country, bringing to an end almost 20 years of a US-led coalition's presence. Years of training and investment by NATO went into vain, as the US Army barely put up any defense against the Taliban. The Taliban entered Kabul almost without any resistance. After the Taliban's victory, China, potentially supported by Russia, expressed their will to extend formal recognition to the Taliban as Afghanistan's legitimate government, as well as with the peaceful reconstruction of critical infrastructure in Afghanistan. An old proverb tells us, "The enemy of my enemy is my friend." But the victory of Taliban forces is wresting control over most of Afghanistan from the government of President Ashraf Ghani may complicate affairs for three countries whose relationship with the United States is always fraught and often hostile. Leaders of China, Turkey, and Moscow didn't shed any tears nor objections while watching Ghani's American and NATO army fail miserably to pull out their mission in Afghanistan. That mission, which cost them 2 decades and more than 3,000 American and other NATO lives with trillions of dollars added to the US national debt. But the rise of the Taliban creates its own set of challenges for leaders in China, Turkey, and Russia, each of which sees themselves as a vital regional power broker. Developing a great relationship with the Taliban for the past decade, and with a recent high-profile official visit by the Taliban delegation led by the group's number 2 leader Abdul Ghani Baradar on July 28th, China sees itself as having finally been on the right horse in Afghanistan. Since the Taliban's takeover of the country, China has expressed a unique level of positive response, political endorsement, and diplomatic support of the Taliban. However, there are wild debates ongoing in China as to what the best approach is moving forward to a poor, unstable, and destabilizing neighbor. Having declared the Afghan Taliban a crucial military and political power in Afghanistan, China's abandonment of the former Ghani government and its balancing diplomacy was swift despite high-level engagement with both parties as recently as July. China has not moved to accept the Taliban or the Taliban-led regime yet. However, such acceptance is mentioned in the many messages China has sent. On August 18th, the Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson subtly stated that acceptance of a government must wait until the government is organized, indicating that after the Taliban proves its government, China's recognition will ensure. One day later, the Foreign Ministry praised the Taliban's good, positive, and pragmatic behaviors and called for the global community to break its stereotyped judgments of the organization. China seems to have decided on 2 preliminary appraisals about the future. The first is about the Taliban's victory and its sustainability. There may be air pockets of territory and opponent organizations that remain outside the Taliban's control, but China doesn't mind them as posing risky calls, especially now that America's retreat appears irreversible. The second concerns the Taliban's enhanced behavior. China sees the Taliban as becoming more reasonable and practical, based on the group's current outreach to neighboring nations and the policies it has declared so far, including its pledge to uphold women's rights. The 2 appraisals indicate that Chinese leaders believe that the Taliban is here to stay and is no longer as radical and extremist as it was 20 years ago. Changing this belief into practical strategies, China will likely give the Taliban the benefit of the doubt and support the group as long as it doesn't repeat anything offensive, especially concerning its support for terrorist groups. Indeed, terrorist threats are the most significant business Chinese leaders have in Afghanistan, The fact that other countries, such as Russia, share similar aspects about the Taliban bolsters China's position. The U.S. failure and messy retreat are quite vital in China's playbook. On the one hand, China has left no stone unturned in its attempt to threaten Washington and the democratic model it tried to root in Afghanistan. For China, the defeat of the Western model once again proves that Western democracy is not a universal value, let alone a successful one. This is crucial for China as a major validation of its evidence for an alternative system. On the other hand, China also sees the failure of the United States as an opportunity for China to illustrate that its agnostic approach to political systems and governance, as well as its preference for building peace through economic evolution, might be a better approach toward collapsed states than the militarized nation building the West has attempted. In their way, if China could restore and stabilize Afghanistan, the China model would prove superior, and consequently, China would be proved superior to the United States as a global leader. China is ready to move in to fill the void left by the United States and utilize Afghanistan's natural resources and significant location for the Belt and Road Initiative. In this blueprint, if China steps carefully and assists the Taliban at this convenient moment, there is a potential for China to engineer and create useful support in Afghanistan as a diplomatic asset. What is Russia looking for exactly? No scope of instability from Afghanistan to bordering Central Asian states, no terrorist attacks against Russia from groups based in Afghanistan, and no support for radicalism in Russia. As the takeover seemed expected, a Taliban delegation visited Moscow in July to satisfy Russian concerns on these grounds. Like China, Russia would also like to see a comprehensive government form, but it cares less about the domestic workings of Afghanistan and has few interests in the country. Russia is depending much on China in this Afghan matter, as Andrei Serenko, head of the Center of Contemporary Afghan Studies, said, "It'll most likely have to cooperate with China. China has all the trump cards now. China influences Pakistan. China retains its position inside Afghanistan. They hold the Taliban accountable." So the Russian strategy regarding Afghanistan is now going to depend on China. It'll adjust to China more and more. The older brother Beijing will play the first violin here. At the moment, Russia is in no rush to accept the Taliban as a legitimate government. The Taliban are still designated as a terrorist group in Russia, but Russian leadership has made it clear that its policy is one of obligation. It seems that Russia prefers that Afghanistan remain a unitary state and is unlikely to support opponent groups. All the countries are adopting certain hedging strategies. Among them, China seems most eager to venture into Afghanistan. However, Chinese interest is still subject to strong calls for warning. If the Taliban's victory proves unsustainable, China and Russia will most likely join hands to form a mutual security policy to seal off any spillover consequence from Afghanistan. Recent proposals of developing a buffer zone in Tajikistan indicate preparations in this direction. However, the key of that zest into real and meaningful actions awaits to be seen. China might move faster than Western countries to embrace the Taliban government, but major investments, political and economic, will depend on the appearance of sustainable stability and the true colors the Taliban shows. And well, that's all for today. Thanks for watching the video. Give this video a big thumbs up and let me know your thoughts in the comment box. For more exciting videos, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon for notifications. I'll be back with another exciting video soon. Till then, check out our channel for more exciting videos and stay tuned.